In this video, we'll examine the troubleshooting tools available in Windows 8. When troubleshooting, it's best to start with the least obtrusive method that solves your problem and then move on to more advanced methods. We'll review the tools in that order. The tools we'll be covering are System Restore, Refresh, Reset, and then Advanced Options. All of these tools can be reached from one place. First, open the charm bar. This can be accomplished by either holding the Windows key and pressing the C key, or, on a device with a touch interface, by swiping from the right-hand side of the screen towards the center. Select Settings, and then select PC Settings at the bottom. This opens the PC Settings app. Select General at the left to see the general settings on the right. Scroll this down to the bottom. While you'll see an option to refresh your device and an option to remove everything and reinstall Windows, these tools are also in the Advanced Startup that contains other features as well, so we'll discuss all the tools from there. Select Advanced Startup. This will bring you to the Advanced Startup screen. Select Troubleshoot. You'll see Refresh and Reset again, but you'll want to select Advanced Options. Now you should see the first tool we're going to discuss, System Restore, which is the least obtrusive tool. It rolls back system files to a previous system restore point. Restore points can be made manually, but are also created automatically. Documents and personal files are not changed, but applications installed after the restore point was created will need to be reinstalled. This should be the first tool you try when troubleshooting because it leaves your data intact and only affects recently installed applications. Now select the back arrow to reach the troubleshoot menu again. We'll look at the second tool now, Refresh. When you perform a refresh, your personal files and personalizations won't change. PC settings will be changed to defaults. Windows Store apps will be kept, but apps installed from disks or websites will be removed. A list of removed apps will be saved on the desktop. Next, we'll look at the third tool, Reset. A reset will return your computer to its out-of-box factory default conditions. It'll remove your personal files and apps, as well as reset all settings to default. This is similar to what Toshiba has previously called a system recovery. Finally, there are a few tools that should be used only by advanced users. The first of these is the System Image Recovery. From the Troubleshoot screen, select Advanced Options. On this screen, you should see System Image Recovery. System Image Recovery allows you to recover to a previously created system image. A system image is a file that contains a snapshot of everything on the PC. Next, I'd like to talk about Use a Device. From the Advanced Options screen, select the back arrow that takes you to the Troubleshoot screen. Then select the back arrow again to the screen titled Choose an Option. You should see Use a Device. This can be used to boot from a CD, DVD, network, or USB device. If you've created system recovery media on a USB stick or DVDs, you can use this to boot from your USB stick or DVD and perform a recovery. Finally, I'd like to mention the Toshiba Maintenance Utility. You may see this while looking at the advanced troubleshooting tools. Caution! This deletes all of your partitions completely. It removes your ability to use any recovery options. This is only for advanced users. Finally, these are all the tools you need to troubleshoot your Windows 8 computer. For more information, visit support.toshiba.com.